emblem O'Neill, familiarly known to my family, friends, and acquaintances as Blemmy. Because the burden of my years and infirmities is heavy upon me. And I realize the end of my life is near. Do hereby bury my last will and testament in the mind of my master. He will not know it is there until after I am dead. Then remembering me in his loneliness, he will suddenly know of this testament. And I ask him then inscribe it as a memorial to me. I have little in the way of material things to men. They do not set great store upon things. They do not waste their days hoarding property. They do not ruin their sleep worrying about how to keep the objects they have and to obtain the objects they have not. There is nothing of value I have to bequeath except my love and faith. These I leave to those who have loved me, to my master and mistress, who I know will mourn me . But if I should list all those who have loved me, it would force my master to write a book. Perhaps it is vain of me to boast when I am so near to death, which returns all beasts and vanities to dust. But I have always been an extremely lovable dog. In time of sorrow and a reason for added joy in their happiness. It is painful for me to think that even in death I should cause them pain. Let them remember that while no dog has ever had a happier life, and this I owe to their love and care for me. Now that I have grown blind and deaf and lame, and even my sense of smell fails me, so that my pride has sunk to a sink, humiliated.
My mistress say,
Fixed on me in admiration, and for all his faults, I hereby wish him the happiness I know will be his. In my old regret, but also with happiness.